President Trump is warning U.S. trading partners not to do any business with Iran, saying he is asking for world peace. This comes after the president reimposed sanctions on the country Monday. CBS News' Mola Lenghi reports.
Saying he's asking for nothing less than world peace, President Trump tweeted Tuesday, anyone doing business with Iran will not be doing business with the United States. The tweet follows a presidential order reimposing sanctions that the Obama administration suspended under the 2015 multinational nuclear deal with Iran. The sanctions target Iran's gold and metal industries and its auto sector. They also restrict Tehran from using U.S. dollars in financial transactions. In response, German automaker Daimler said it was suspending its activities in Iran.
The White House says it isn't looking for a regime change. It just wants to pressure Tehran to change its behavior.
We want to see a much broader retreat by Iran from their support for international terrorism, their belligerent military activity in the Middle East.
In a joint statement, European foreign ministers said they deeply regret the sanctions and are taking measures to protect EU companies doing legitimate business with Iran. The allies have maintained and remained committed to the 2015 agreement. A second set of sanctions targeting Iran's central bank sector and oil industry go into effect in November. Mola Lenghi, CBS News, The White House.
Huffington Post senior reporter Arthur Delaney is in Washington. Arthur, thanks for joining us.
Thanks for having me.
So this is just the first round of sanctions. What can we expect?
Well, we've already seen from just the mere threat of these sanctions, political unrest in Iran that's related to the effect of the sanctions, you know, hurting the economy and with companies, with these car companies pulling out of plans to expand there. What the Trump administration is hoping is that this pressure will force Iran back to the table to renegotiate the deal, which seems like a long shot at this point.
Well, that's what they're hoping for. Is there any word in Washington about how realistic officials truly think that possibility is?
Well, one reason it's less realistic than the Trump administration might hope is that the other parties to the nuclear deal are still in favor of the deal, which means that imposing strict sanctions, particularly the oil and energy sanctions that would kick in November, will be difficult because these other companies will continue doing, these other countries will still allow their firms to do business with Iran, and that's basically going to create a lot of loopholes to the sanctions that the U.S. wants to impose.
Right. So European allies continue to support the Iran nuclear deal, mostly over concerns about the instability that U.S. sanctions could bring to the region. Do you think that's going to impact the relationships the U.S. has with the allies?
Oh, this is definitely going to have a very negative impact on the relationship that the U.S. has with its European allies. They're in a really tough spot. You know, they thought about potentially blocking some of these sanctions to protect European companies from them if they decide to still do business with Iran. But it's probably symbolic. They're not really going to be able to defend their companies from this because it basically forces companies to choose whether they want to do business in Iran or the United States, which is a much, much larger economy and, you know, much bigger source of profit.
Let's turn to another foreign policy concern. National Security Advisor John Bolton said Tuesday that North Korea has not made progress toward denuclearization. Now, this comes nearly 2 months after President Trump's summit with Chairman Kim Jong-un. What is the U.S.'s next move here?
Well, it's possible that they will send Mike Pompeo back to negotiate with Kim Jong-un. It's incredible to remember that President Trump came back from his meeting with Kim Jong-un and said, sleep well, everybody. North Korea is no longer a nuclear threat. This is a stark reminder that you can't really take anything the president says at face value. The rest of the world looks to other members of his administration for what's really going on. So it's especially in light of the Iran deal, it's incredible to know that we have this sort of unreliable narrator as president of the United States.
Well, and it's interesting to hear, though, as the president continues to hit the campaign trail, he is, of course, trying to cast this as a much different narrative than what the facts actually show, and his supporters continue to stand by him. Let's turn to another topic. President Trump's lawyer, Rudy Giuliani, plans to send a letter to Bob Mueller this week, the special counsel, regarding his request to interview President Trump. Now, it's been reported that a decision has not been reached, and Giuliani said, quote, we have a real reluctance about allowing any questions about obstruction. What do you think it will take for President Trump and Bob Mueller to finally reach an agreement?
Well, this is the latest in a long series of letters that have been going back and forth between the White House and the Mueller investigation for most of the year. And you have to remember that Trump's previous lawyer, John Dowd, actually resigned because Trump wasn't taking his advice to just refuse to sit for an interview with Mueller. And so the president keeps saying, you know, I'd love to do it. Maybe it could hasten the end of this. But Giuliani is basically stalling because they know if Trump does sit down for an interview, his penchant for saying untrue things would put him at risk of committing perjury. So it strikes me as a delaying tactic, which is ironic, considering how often you hear the president complain that this witch hunt is just going on and never ends.
All right. To be continued. Arthur Delaney, thanks very much, Arthur.
Thanks for having me.